Hi, I'm Dr. Sunil Richardson. I'm a craniofacial surgeon based out of South India and also of the Middle East. We have this young man with us today. He's had multiple surgeries before at a hospital in the north of this large country of India. Since the year...
Kab to aapka pehla operation? Uske pehle jo bachche chote the?
So 1999, he had his first surgery. And his last was in 2012. He's had multiple surgeries, major interventions for his condition, which is called a hemangioma. Hemangioma is nothing but a blood tumor. Basically, the lesions are filled with blood, and that causes disfigurement and also difficulty for those patients. We can have a closer look at how the lesions look for him. Let's come closer. So, what we actually have is a hemangioma now that you see. He's pursing his lips and hence it doesn't look that big. But if you see that, that's how it is. So it's compressible. Now you see the blood has drained out, but the blood is going to fill back on. You can see some lines here. This is the scar from the earlier surgery. There's one there, there's another one there, some blobs there, and similar situation here. You see, it fills up more rapidly. But this is a hemangioma again, and it also extends all the way here. Okay, and this is a scar from his earlier surgery. He's had a surgery all across his chin. You can see there, but the hemangioma is growing beneath that. Now this is what's happening outside. Now let's look inside. Dheere se mukh kholo beta, open your mouth. See, it's extending all the way in. And open your mouth nicely and jeev dikhao. And there's his tongue. So large hemangioma sitting on the tongue as well. See that? Posterior extension. There's also an extension in the floor of the mouth. You can see here, I can feel with both my hands. Okay. So bite man karo. So what we're planning to do today is basically resecting a lot of this hemangioma. Is not going to be easy if you're going to do that, and also reconstruct in such a way that he's going to look much better cosmetically. So we're going to keep cosmesis mind, at the same time try and remove as much of this lesion as possible. He wants me to do the lip and the chin and the submental area first, so we're going to do that today. We're thinking it's going to take about 3 hours to do that. We'll need help of laser, cautery, some different types of suturing, very low blood pressures and so many other things in order to finish this. We've also taken an MR angiogram. We also have a few plebolids, stones, and then primary surgery this afternoon. We've also got some blood and everything reserved, and I hope it comes out very well. Thank you.
About to start this patient versus large hematoma. See the lip? It's extending. Also below, that's the chin, and there you see even beneath, submental region. MRI says about 17 centimeters in dimension. It's also extending into the mouth. Can you get that scope, please? And into the tongue. Just show you the MRI. Yeah. You can see the tongue, how the lesion is popping out. There you see. The posterior extent is almost the base. It's also extending to the floor of the mouth. Sizing and reconstructing the lip for this patient, lower lip and the chin, all the way up to the chin and also from intraoral. You can give me a small. Just retract this way so we can show them inside the lips. Gently. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, all the way down. Yeah. One more retractor maybe to show the depth. You can see there's hardly any hemangiomatous tissue left in the lip now. Excised 95 to 99% of it. That's the sulcus depth. You can retract some more. Okay, that's the sulcus depth. So it's clear there as well. Okay, stop. Take it down. Awesome. Because you open that, just that across. Okay, that's how he looks in his profile.